The featured company is a paid client of Proactive Group Holdings, and this recording is disseminated by Proactive on its behalf.
So, you know, we created these batteries, the first batteries in North America, created from North American critical minerals, and they were created using the phosphate from our property. Because of that, you know, we need to get our resource into production as soon as possible.
Hello, you're watching Proactive. I'm joined by First Phosphate CEO, John Passalacqua. John, very good to speak with you. I hear you're doing a capital raise and a strategic investor is stepping in with funds. How are you going to use these funds to accelerate your near-term exploration and development goals?
Yeah, thank you, Stephen. So yes, we have an existing investor who would like to top up. And we have opened the capital raise just for this investor and for some other existing shareholders potentially. Basically, these funds will help us, you know, along the roads with our current drilling program, which is to do a 30,000 meter drill program, finish off the drilling so that we can build a block model for the resource. That'll be the end of our drilling, and then we can get to our feasibility study at some point mid next year.
John, you consistently highlighted First Phosphate's vision of a fully integrated North American LFP battery supply chain. How does this race fit into that roadmap, and what specific milestones should investors look for next?
Yeah, so that's really important. I'm going to show you the battery that I have right here. So, you know, we created these batteries, the first batteries in North America, created from North American critical minerals, and they were created using the phosphate from our property. Because of that, you know, we need to get our resource into production as soon as possible so that we can then use that phosphate, which is now qualified, to make batteries for the North American LFP battery industry. And as you know, Stephen, it's a pertinent need because China has threatened just a few weeks ago to cut off rare earth supplies, computer chips, but also LFP technology and the components thereof. So with what we have, this really pure igneous phosphate resource, the sooner we can get into production, the better. We're aiming for 2029.
John, with growing demand for lithium iron phosphate materials and recent interest in North American sources, how does this funding strengthen your competitive position in the broader LFP ecosystem?
Yeah, I mean, look, the company is already very well funded. We've got between $18 to $19 million in the bank right now. This funding just adds on to that. It just gets us a longer and longer runway. So far, you know, we're fully capitalized until pretty much the end of 2026. This just gives us extra runway. And it's great when it's coming from existing shareholders, right, that support us. They're long holders. They want to become more long in the company. So it's just great to see, you know, that kind of support from existing shareholders.
Well, John, I hope you'll continue to keep us updated with your progress. Thank you very much for speaking with us today.
Yeah, thank you, Stephen. Much appreciated.
John Passalacqua, the CEO of First Phosphate.
The featured company is a paid client of Proactive Group Holdings, and this recording is disseminated by Proactive on its behalf. It is for informational purposes only and does not constitute investment advice, an offer, or a solicitation to buy or sell any securities. Viewers should conduct their own research and consult a qualified financial advisor before making investment decisions. The views expressed are those of the speaker and do not necessarily reflect those of Proactive Group Holdings, trading as Proactive Investors, or its affiliates. No responsibility is accepted for any loss arising from reliance on the information presented.